Many students look forward to basketball season beginning tonight. How Razorback fans will see this upcoming season.
A food recovering campaign gives students a way to reduce the amount of food waste. The importance behind this.
How one Pat Walker health program promotes talking it out. This is UATV.
Welcome to your Tuesday night's newscast. I'm Ashlyn Brothers.
And I'm Tristan Hill. Thank you for joining us. The U of A basketball team takes on its 97th season tonight against Rice University. The event will take place at Bud Walton Arena, where the first 500 students will get a must-bust t-shirt. Rice University will be the first D1 team the Hogs will compete against this season.
The expectations are very high. This should be to me, it should be a top 25 year. I mean, coming from last year, we have so many more plays and more excitement bringing to Bud this year. So, I mean, it's going to be a big year for us.
One lucky student will win a pair of Apple AirPods, and the new metal detector entry protocol will be introduced tonight.
With basketball season starting, students received an email today from the university regarding parking. Cars needed to be moved from the red areas by 5 in the evening, and those who fail to move their cars each basketball game will be towed 2 hours prior to the event. Students and faculty can park their cars in the green area on your map.
Even though elections will not be until next year, candidates can file now at the courthouse. Citizens looking to be a justice of the peace can ask their political party about the filing fee. Lawallen says students will be affected locally by the results of the election.
So your justice of the peace as an individual on campus makes decisions, helps, you know, makes laws. So that definitely has an impact on you as a student.
She also adds that students should make sure early that they are registered to vote in the upcoming election.
Students looking to vote in the 2020 election can find applications on the Arkansas government's website. The website provides information regarding voter registration applications. Non-Arkansas residents who want to vote can fill out an application online or request an application through the mail.
A survey done by APA.org shows that 21% of counseled students were diagnosed with severe mental health concerns. The CAPS program through Pat Walker Health Center continues to try to assist students through whatever they may be going through. UATV's Delaney Osborne joins us live with more.
The Pat Walker Health Center isn't just home to flu shots and nausea medicine. It's also home to different mental health services that students can choose to utilize for free. One of those services happens to be the Let's Talk program. According to their website, students can stop in for an informal, friendly, and confidential consultation. Consultations are free and are taken on a walk-in basis. Students who attend will be seen on a first-come, first-served basis as well. I spoke with one student on campus who was diagnosed with bipolar disorder and agrees that CAPS is a great resource for students to use.
They have helped me significantly get through some very bad times, so It is useful. It is worth it to go see CAPS if you need to see CAPS. So,
all consultations are private and in two different locations on campus, one in Leflar Hall in the Law Center, and in one in Gerhardt Hall during two different times of the week. I'm reporting for UATV. I'm Delaney Osborne.
According to the Let's Talk website, the program was developed to reach students in distress and increase access to mental health services and resources.
Roughly 40% of food produced ends up being wasted in the U.S. A group on campus looks to lower that number. Student volunteers from Razorback Food Recovery partnered with the catering service Chartwells for the Stop Food Waste campaign. Food waste remains an issue for a number of reasons. One student, a part of Razorback Food Recovery, says it's important for students to be aware.
With programs like RFR, with other programs, whenever you save that food, whenever you don't eat that leftover food, it could save a pan in the back that could go towards someone that really needs a meal right now.
The Stop Food Waste campaign ends Wednesday after lasting for 10 days.
The university hosted a discussion with Fayetteville Mayor Lionel Jordan, focusing on the city's sustainability efforts and policies. The event starts at 6 Wednesday night, and it will take place at the Bell Engineering Center in room 2286. Students are encouraged to go, as there will be free Chipotle provided. The university's Office for Sustainability invites students to a lunch and learn Thursday afternoon. During the lunch, the topic of conversation will center around agriculture and its effect on the climate, environmentally friendly dining options, and food waste. Students can register for the event through eventbrite.com.
November typically means colder weather, and it also means flu season has started. UATV's Bryce Helms has the story. Bryce?
That's right, Ashlyn. The Centers for Disease Control says that approximately 10% of Americans will catch the flu virus this season. On a campus of around 30,000, students need to remain vigilant. At the University of Arkansas, approximately 2,700 students will catch the virus. Students can catch the flu from pretty much anywhere.
Think about your cell phones, for instance. How often are you touching your cell phone with your hands while you're eating, or bringing your cell phone into the bathroom? And so, you know, it's really important to make sure that you're disinfecting those everyday used items like your laptops, your cell phones. And then, of course, you know, just making sure that your area is clean.
The Pat Walker Health Center has reported that there have been 19 cases of the flu already on campus. They encourage every student to get their flu shot.
Your flu shot really isn't that bad. You just get one poke in your arm and you feel fine afterwards. It's easy to do.
The Pat Walker Health Center offers a walk-in flu clinic every day from 3 to 5 p.m. The flu shot, only takes about 30 seconds to administer.
So I'm ready, wherever you are. All right, and just like that, done.
All in all, I was in and out of the Pat Walker Health Center flu vaccine clinic in under a minute. Students are encouraged to be proactive with their health over the coming months and to do their part to keep themselves and everyone around them healthy.
One important thing to remember is that, you know, if you get your flu vaccine early enough, it's going to help prevent you contracting the flu over the entire flu season, which can range anywhere from the beginning of October all the way until April.
Brown told me that the Pat Walker Health Center had already administered over 1,500 flu shots since the clinic began in October. Reporting live for UATV, I'm Bryce Helms.
Thanks, Bryce. The students can get their flu shot in the immunization clinic on the first floor of the Pat Walker Health Center.
First-generation students, graduates, and those who support the first-generation population will be celebrated in the Union this Friday. The I'm First event recognizes and celebrates students, faculty, and staff members who identify as first-generation at the University of Arkansas. Stickers handed out to everyone at the event highlight the growing number of first-generations.
And a graduate salute will take place starting tomorrow for the 2019 graduating class. The salute will take place at the University Bookstore on Garland. Students can find out information about the graduation announcements, diploma frames, class rings, and much more. Caps and gowns will be available at the bookstore, as well as promotional discounts and free giveaways.
The UREC challenges students to attend fitness classes for a prize.
Find out what you can win by completing the challenge. November leaves no room for excuses when it comes to fitness this month, with No Excuse November. The UREC will be giving stamp cards to participants who participate in group fitness classes from now until December 12th. Students can complete the fitness challenge by attending 12 fitness classes.
It's very important to work out, in my opinion. Not because I'm an athlete, but I think just to have a, you know, healthy lifestyle and for it to rub off on your family, because there is a problem with obesity in the United States. So,
classes will be held in the Hyper, UREC Cycle Studio, and UREC Fitness Center. Students who complete the challenge will receive a pair of free UREC performance socks.
The University of Arkansas Bookstore is looking for some new management. Last week, representatives from Barnes & Noble and Follett Booksellers came to the U of A to present how they would improve the shop. UATV's Michael Atkinson joins us live in front of the bookstore to tell us about those presentations.
Students are finding new ways to rent textbooks, including Amazon, which leaves the university bookstore to have to adapt to a changing university.
The one-stop one-stop shop for all things University of Arkansas. We'll see some new changes soon.
We would like the bookstore to be the go-to destination for textbooks, course materials.
Fessler says some new management will create more than a store.
We were really focused on creating a space where members of the community could find a place where they could experience a little bit of the passion that so many people have for the University of Arkansas.
Barnes & Noble presented last Monday discussing their big industry ties to companies like Urban Outfitters and Lululemon for new products. Follett addressed their billion-dollar franchise as well as recent renovations to TCU, NYU, and other top universities. But the need for new management might come from the need for more money. University financial statements put the bookstore's revenue at $11 million, down nearly 25% in 10 years. That's the lowest amount of money the bookstore has brought in since 2002, when the university gained full operation of the bookstore. Both booksellers brought new ideas and additions to increase profits, focusing on diversity, accessibility, and affordable textbooks.
Obviously, being a low-cost leader there is very important to us.
These changes could have big effects on the whole university, but none more than on the current bookstore staff.
Some people are a little worried about it, and some people are like, it should be fine, you know, it's going to help us.
But both Barnes & Noble and Follett have agreed that current bookstore employees aren't going anywhere.
Any firm that came in would be required to take on those current full-time employees at their current salary.
And Duke says that new management might be the help the bookstore is looking for.
So it'll be kind of nice to get a refresh, because I think that is kind of what we need.
Now, Fessler said that the vetting process of narrowing it down to just two booksellers, Barnes & Noble and Follett, was a thorough survey, seeing which booksellers matched their ideals with the universities. Reporting live outside the bookstore for UATV, I am Michael Atkinson.
Vice Chancellor Kel Fessler says that the committee hopes to have a new manager picked and implemented by the spring.
The campus community is encouraged to come together to help honor veterans. The Armed Forces Alumni Society will receive special recognition during the football game this Saturday. All military veteran students, staff, faculty, and alumni are invited to a Veterans Day ceremony the following Monday at 5 in the evening. Find out how you can get involved within the esports community on campus.
I think it's active community. It's growing. And it's something fun to get into if there's a game you like.
A new security system makes its way to Arkansas Athletics. How this affects fans entering games.
The Super Smash Bros. Competitive scene around campus boomed with the release of the newest game last December. Two members of the UARC esports team won over $200 Saturday at a local tournament. The UARC esports team hosts tournaments every Friday night in the JB Hunt in room 234 with $1 admission.
A new season in Arkansas athletics brings new security measures. David Clox joins us live with more. David?
Fans have been filing into Bud Walton Arena to watch the Hogs take on the Rice Owls. But from now on, before they do, they'll have to take one extra step.
Starting with basketball season on November 5th, fans will be required to walk through metal detectors at all entrance gates at Bud Walton Arena, with detectors being put in at Baumwalker Stadium and Razorback Stadium in time for their upcoming seasons. Senior Associate Athletic Director for Public Relations Kevin Trainer says the new safety measures are part of a Southeastern Conference mandate that the athletic department has expanded on.
The SEC best practices and passed a policy last year to have all football stadiums by 2020 include metal detectors. So we'll be in compliance with that, as well as enhancing the safety for our fans at all of our events at football, basketball, and baseball.
Trainer says that the technological advancements allow fans to keep personal items in their pockets as they walk through the detectors, which helps fans get in the door faster.
When they approach it, it's not like the airport where we want you to take off your shoes or belt and things like that. Keep those in your pocket, go through either, put those in your hands if you'd like, but it's a safe and efficient way to scan this crowds coming in to make sure that we deliver a safe and enjoyable game day.
Trainer says even though the new systems may be a slight inconvenience for fans, they are one of the best ways to keep fans safe while also getting them in the door quickly.
Know that their time is precious. We want to get them in the venue for tip-off or for kickoff as soon as possible. So we really feel like that we've gotten a system that will work and to serve both of those purposes very well.
Trainer said that right now there are no future plans to bring metal detectors to other U of A venues on campus. Reporting live for UATV, I'm David Cox.
Thanks, David. The clear bag policy is still in effect.
Students can meet the head coaches of the Razorback teams on campus. Hot Dogs with Head Hogs takes over campus. The coaches will be set up at the Union Mall tomorrow from 11 to 2 in the afternoon. Students can get a caricature picture drawn of them, and Tusk will also be making an appearance.
One Razorback parts ways with his team, and one recently got suspended.
That's right. Find out who with UATV Sports after the break.
Welcome back to UATV Sports. I'm Madison Hartley. There's breaking news in the studio tonight. Reggie Chaney is suspended from the basketball team indefinitely. Coach Musselman said it was for violation of team rules. UATV Sports will have more on that later this week. A standout football player said his goodbyes to college football career Sunday. Senior tight end C.J. O'Grady was taken off the roster with only 3 games left in the season. The player set out of Saturday's game against Mississippi State after a suspension. This was his 3rd time to be suspended from playing for Arkansas, with the first dating back to Coach Brett Bielema. In O'Grady's final statement, he wished the best of luck to his teammates to finish out the year strong and thanked the fan base for their support. The senior has had an impressive college football career. He was selected for this year's preseason Mackey Award watch list. O'Grady will end the 2019 season with 3 touchdowns. The total touchdowns he acquired at Arkansas is 12, which makes him Arkansas's all-time leader in touchdown receptions as a tight end. O'Grady said he will graduate in December, which will make him the 2nd member in his family to earn a degree. A pro hog made his NFL debut with the Denver Broncos Saturday night. Brandon Allen helped lead his team to victory as Broncos starting quarterback. The Broncos won 24-19 against the Cleveland Browns. Allen threw 2 touchdowns as Denver starter. His last starting position was at the 2016 Liberty Bowl as the Razorbacks played Kansas State Wildcats. This year makes Allen's 4th season in the NFL and his 1st season to be used during a game. Allen was initially drafted to the Jaguars in 2016 during the 6th round. Broncos head coach Vic Fangio said he was overall very pleased with his play. Another former Razorback made the NFL headlines Sunday night. Los Angeles Chargers tight end Hunter Henry caught a team high of 7 passes for 84 yards. The Chargers caused an upset against the Green Bay Packers, winning 26-11. The Eric Musselman era tips off tonight at Bud Walton Arena. The Hogs open for their 97th season of basketball against the Rice Owls of Houston. Expectations for the Razorbacks are low under the new head coach, with the media tabbing them to finish 11th in the SEC. Musselman was given the reins as head coach after Coach Mike Anderson was let go after 8 years at the helm, gathering a 169-102 record and 5 postseason appearances. The game is already underway. You can see it on the SEC Network Plus right now. Moving on from the team as a whole, one player is being recognized for his expectations this season. Sophomore guard Isaiah Joe was voted preseason All-SEC 2nd team yesterday. Joe was crucial to the success of the Razorbacks had last year, setting the Arkansas single season record in 3-pointers made with 113. In addition to the preseason All-SEC honor, Joe is one of the 20 players across the country to start the season in contention for the Jerry West Shooting Guard of the Year. That's all for UATV Sports tonight, but we'll be back with more after the break.
Halloween took over last week, and now we celebrate another day. Today marks National Donut Day.
Now, the history of donuts is a little bit disputed. There's not a specific reason that today is the day for donuts, but we are certainly not complaining.
No, Tristan, we are not. What's your favorite flavor donut?
See, I'm classic. I'm a glazed man myself.
Oh, really? Okay, I like chocolate, but it has to have sprinkles on it.
Okay.
Yeah, no, that is definitely my favorite. I also like the long ones.
Right, okay.
But as my grandma would say, see you around like a donut. I'm Ashlyn Brothers.
And I'm Tristan Hill. Have a great night.